but you got the sweetest love, and that's why I love you.
Finishing your novel when you're approaching the red zone time limit of your deadline. That's where I am now. I've got about one more week where I will be in the red zone for my book. The book is not complete. It's disjointed. There's 50 or 60,000 words all over the place. This happens because of a flow, which is not a bad thing. If you can flow about 50, 60, 70, 80,000 words, wonderful. But you really only need to flow about 40,000 to complete your story. Now, what am I talking about? I'm talking about when the story just starts popping out of your head and you see it playing before you like a movie. And your fingers move as fast as they've ever moved, getting down what you see. In my case, I often dream my stories. So I try to wake up and capture that dream on paper before the dream escapes me. Sometimes it has to happen in the middle of the night. You wake up and you go, oh my gosh, that was great. And you have to scribble it on a pad, which I keep a pad by the side of my bed. That is the best way to catch your muse. Sometimes muse are fun little creatures, and they like to come in the middle of the night and tap you on the shoulder and go, and then take off. And then in the morning you think, blast! You know, so you catch up in the morning, and while she's going, you grab her around the throat and go, come on to the office. And you make her sit and work. And sometimes you're just too tired because you worked way too hard the night before, and you just scribble out some stuff and hope that you can figure out what you wrote the next day. Okay, there's different ways people catch flows, and that's one of them. Another way are concentrated, more practical ways where people actually have an outline, and they have action outlines. They have they leave off the mundane. They have action topics, murders, characters, romance, sex scenes, whatever. I should say love scenes, but because that's another thing. We're going to talk about genres, because there is a difference between sex scenes, love scenes, romance, and porn and erotica. We'll talk about it later. Anyway, but you have your scenes all marked out. And when you catch a flow, you may jump between all of those scenes. Okay? Right now, my flow has me capturing the essence of my characters. So it's very disjointed. I have a character who's realizing he was in love with someone. And so I'm writing little scenes, little glimpses into his introspection on that. I have another character who you're going to love to hate. So I'm creating little scenes, building his character where you realize he's a creepy little mouse and he's up to something. Then I have the main character that I'm trying to draw her up to where you go, now I know why everybody thinks they did it, thinks this character did it, thinks she did it. I'm going to go ahead and tell you. Everybody thinks she did it. And I've got to draw that up. Then it dawned on me, with the title of the book, Accident Prone, I'd like to draw without saying it, oh, she's so accident prone. Oh, this was an accident. Accident afterwards, obvious. I'm trying to draw on my title and catch the double entendre there. Without doing that, subtly have the character trip, fall, drop things, break things, yada, 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 to where the reader goes, she's really accident prone. So that in the end, an accident such as this saves the day without saying the words accident.